All right, we got a new question here. After reading through some of the judgments in Revelation, it seems like it's describing some sort of nuclear holocaust. Is there any other scripture that might fit with this? Well, I'd have to say, yeah, I think so. Both the Old and the New Testaments actually describe an event that seems to be a nuclear war. In Revelation 9, we read about the third part of mankind being killed by the three plagues of fire, smoke, and sulfur. Zechariah wrote how their flesh shall consume away while they stand on their feet, and their eyes shall consume away in their holes, and their tongue shall consume away in their mouth. Joel wrote in chapter 2, I think, I will show wonders in the heavens and on the earth, blood, fire, and billows of smoke. This appears to be describing a nuclear blast. The scriptures actually give quite a detailed description of a judgment of fire that will be sent to earth in the last days. Revelation chapter 8, we see that a third part of the trees are burned up and all the green grass was burned up. We also read about the judgment of the great whore of Babylon, the city that sits on seven hills, and how God will cause the kings of the earth to hate her and consume her with fire until she will be found no more at all forever. The scriptures do seem to have a lot to say about this coming fire judgment. You know, some folks want to only look at some of these prophecies in their spiritual dimensions. Now, I don't argue with sound spiritual interpretations, as they do offer a lot of really good information, but I don't want to hyper-spiritualize the scriptures into oblivion either. Now, God gave us these warnings so that we're not caught unawares when this stuff hits the fan. The prophet Zechariah in particular describes what seems to be a nuclear exchange in such vivid detail, it's downright scary. He speaks of these flying cylindrical containers that deliver these wicked fire offerings composed of extremely heavy metal, which fly across the face of the whole earth and consume houses and buildings, even the stones thereof, and they even leave this residue behind after the destruction. Zechariah even gives the exact dimensions of the delivery vehicles, the size of the containers that hold the wicked fire offerings, and he even details exactly how the heavy metal mechanism of this evil fire offering is detonated. He identifies exactly who is targeted and even why. Now, before we dig into this particular prophecy, we need to review some Hebrew terms. We have to remember that Zechariah had this vision 2,500 years ago and wrote down what he saw the best he could in a language that most of us today don't speak. Unfortunately, sometimes when we read these things in a straight modern English, we have a hard time deciphering exactly what's going on. This is a place where a good translation of the Old Testament really shines over our modernized and paraphrased versions that we have commonplace in America now. I'm going to be looking up the original Hebrew words in this text using a Strong's Concordance with the Hebrew lexicon. And you can all follow along with me. You can get it for free online, or you can buy one at the bookstore. They're not impossible to find. Now, this particular prophecy I'm talking about is found in Zechariah chapter 5. Now, if you read Zechariah chapter 5 using a modern English paraphrase Bible without checking the Hebrew, you're going to be very confused. You are going to be reading about this woman that is so evil that she's crammed into a wicker basket, and nothing is really going to make sense. But we're not going to do that here. We're just going to read exactly what Zechariah says in the Hebrew language. We're not going to creatively spiritualize it away until it doesn't make any sense. You know, unfortunately, many commentaries have kind of done that on this particular passage. So let's review some of our Hebrew first, and then we'll read what Zechariah wrote back in like 520 BC. The first thing that Zechariah sees in this vision is this giant flying roll. Now, what is a roll? Some Bibles say scroll, but the word here is Megillah, not a scroll like we commonly think that rolls up into the two cylinders. Torah is written on a scroll, rolled up into the two cylinders. Now, a Megillah rolls up into a single cylinder. For example, the book of Esther is on a Megillah. and rolls up into a single roll. You can see here a Megillah is pretty much a cylinder and typically has this common 2-to-1 height to circumference ratio. Zechariah gives the size of this Megillah that he sees flying through the air. He says that it's 20 cubits high and 10 cubits in breadth. Now, the word breadth here is not diameter. Diameter is a Greek measurement. The breadth Zechariah is talking about here is what they call a line cast about. We would call it circumference. Like back in, I think it's 1 Kings maybe, King Solomon was building his house with these giant pillars, 30 cubits in breadth. This was the line cast about, not diameter. They weren't 30 cubits in diameter. To find the diameter of a cylinder, if you want to know how big this flying Megillah was, Zechariah describes, you have to take the breadth and divide it by pi. The Megillah Zechariah saw here was 20 cubits high and 10 cubits in breadth, or line cast about. That comes out to be approximately 5.5 feet in diameter when you do the math. Okay. Now that we know what a Megillah looks like, let's move on. Zechariah is going to go on to describe a woman, or an Isha, that's the Hebrew for woman, that sits in the midst of an ephah, or in some versions they say a basket. Let's look closely at these two words and see exactly what an Isha is and exactly what an ephah is. In the Hebrew, the word Isha can mean two different things. It can either mean a woman, which is what most translations put it into the English, or the exact same word Isha can mean fire offering. It's the exact same word. And you can only tell by the context which one is being used here. An ephah, in some versions they call it a basket, a woman in a basket, or an Isha in a basket. But the word basket is actually ephah. It's more precisely a receptacle for holding a quantity of 40 liters. It's a container, sometimes made of clay. Sometimes it can be a basket, but it has a capacity to hold about 40 liters, kind of like a bushel basket kind of deal, a dry unit of measurement. The NIV and most other modern versions just say basket. But remember, the word here is ephah. When we read through this Zechariah chapter 5, we have to remember that when the Bible translators were putting this passage in English 400 years ago, the idea of a fire offering encased in lead that sat in the midst of an ephah seemed kind of weird to them. So they opted instead for a woman in a basket with a lead lid on it instead. We're going to actually see how since 1945 that this Hebrew word Isha really being a fire offering like it means will make a lot more sense than stuffing some woman into a basket that's flying around and putting a lead lid on it because she's so evil. Now that we have checked some of our Hebrew, and being that we now live in the nuclear age, we might be the first generation to actually understand this prophecy. So let's read Zechariah chapter 5 using the original Hebrew words to keep us on track here.